Hey guys, what's up? It's Scott from Darin Donuts bringing you another gear review. So we'll just dive right into it. As you all know on a previous video, my pack setup is I run the Eberle stock F1 mainframe and I love their Vapor series. Unfortunately, this thing is not invincible. So on a recent hunt, I actually fell down with a 5,000 cubic inch Vapor attached to my mainframe. And if you can see, I got the meat shelf completely bent up. I reached out to Eberle stock, hoping for a Hail Mary. Obviously, it being my fault, they weren't gonna give me a new one as much as I wanted to, and I can't blame them for that, but I love this system, so I had to get a new one. So I went ahead and I bought a new F1 mainframe, but I also bought their new Vapor Series 2500 pack. It used to be called the Vapor 2.0, now they've completely phased out these old Vapors, and I had to try their new one. So I'm gonna be talking about that today. But first, let's touch on a couple of things about the F1 mainframe itself. All right, so the first thing about the F1 mainframe that you guys all wanna know is the price. Right now, on Eberle stock, it retails for $299.00. You throw in taxes and shipping and all that stuff, it's probably gonna put you a little bit over $300. Now, with that being said, they do run very good sales quite often, and there's a lot of other websites and places that you're able to find this on for a little bit cheaper, and it does help ease that financial strain. Now, the F1 mainframe is 4 pounds, 5 ounces. It's about 26 inches tall, and it's 11 inches wide. Now, this is the standard one. I don't run the tall one because I'm not a super tall guy myself. I don't have the dimensions on that one off the top of my head, but I know I touch on it on my original F1 mainframe video, and if you get online, you can be able to check those out. Now, this thing is also internal frame, so it's got this nice heavy duty solid metal frame. Now I know I have to buy a new one because my frame bent, but I will tell you right now, I put this thing through the ringer and back. It's not the first time I've just fallen on it completely and been able to get up and walk away. Unfortunately, this one just caught a rock at the right angle at the right time, and you know, it was my pack's time. Now, the cool thing about the F1 mainframe, it is the base of their eMod system. eMod is the Eberle stock modular system. So while I run the Vapor series packs, I also have some of their Batwings, and they have about 20 other different packs and various setups and variations of things that you can use to customize and contour this exactly how you want it. There have been hunts where I've ran my 2500 with a Batwing or two Batwings. I've ran my 5000. They now have lids that we're gonna be talking about as well today. So you can get online and you can find all sorts of their different packs that attach to this. Right now, how I have this attached is through their zippers. As you can see, it also has a bunch of different buckles that you can just buckle things in on. And inside of here, it does still have its MOLLE laser cut holes that you can weave your MOLLE through and attach things that way. So it's really however you want. Also, the nice thing about this is with these packs, it gives this internal space right here, so you still have your internal meat shelf, or if you so desire, and I have these real pretty tight, but you can clip them all the way around and you can have your external meat shelves out here. So this is one of the reasons why I love this pack. That being said, this is still my old pack. So let's dive in and take a look at my new pack. All right, so this is my brand new Eberle stock F1 mainframe and Vapor 2500 pack. Little less beat up, I'm still running their Mirage camo. They have a patented camo system. They call it Doppelganger. It comes in three different colors. You have Mirage, you have Mountain, you have Sky, each one a little bit different, different colors, different hues, depending on the environment that you are hunting in. I personally just like the look of Mirage better, and I feel like it's a more overall camo system, whether I'm up in the mountains, in the pines, in Arizona hunting in the desert, back in Michigan hunting in the woods, it all just blends in. Now they usually have five different colors. They have these three doppelgangers, and they'll also give you a flat dark earth or a military green. So if you want to go with solid colors, you do have that option for the nice neutral tan or that OD green that'll also blend in. Now, while I already have my Vapor series already attached, when they send it to you, it does come in this nice little convenient carrying case That way, when you're not using it, you can roll it up, put it away. It folds up nice and easy. You don't got to worry about your wife yelling at you for having all your hunting gear everywhere. You can just put it in here somewhere, forget it, and it's nice and simple. I personally use these for med bags, for kill kits, for a bunch of other needs for storage and organization when I'm out hunting. They work perfectly. It's a very heavy duty ripstop material in the back, if you can see that. The mesh up here is very sturdy. I've never had one break or anything like that. So that is another option. They have a bunch of different uses and sky's the limit to your imagination. So now we'll talk about some of the differences. What's the difference in their new vapor packs versus their old vapor packs? The first one that's pretty noticeable is a different color scheme. Up front, this nice little stretch material that they have up front that is, again, very durable, rip resistant, is slightly different color, and they moved their logo right here so it stands out a little bit more. On the old ones, if you can see it, they had it right along the side in the camo. Now it is just directly on the front. That being said, the design is still the same. So inside of here, you have a small little front pocket, plenty of storage for all your quick, easy to need access items. You can have your buddy grab it for you when you're on hiking, or you can just drop your pack, grab it out, and you don't have to go digging through everything. Now, when you do want to go into your main pack and go digging through everything, it opens up nice, wide, and deep, and it holds 2,800 cubic inches. I know it's a little weird, it's a Vapor 2500, but it holds 28 cubic inches. What that also transfers over to you weird people that use liters is it's 45.8 liters. Now this thing is going to run you $199, straight off Everly stock. Now the pack itself again comes in five different colors. You have that Flat Earth, the OD Green, and then you have their doppelganger camos, the Mirage, the Mountain, and the Sky. I'm running Mirage on Mirage. You can mix, you can match, you can do whatever you want. Customization is your baby. So the other big thing about this pack is how light it is. It only weighs 1.55 pounds. So that's a super light pack, but it packs a big bang for its buck. It's 25 inches tall, it's 11 inches wide, and it's up to 9 inches deep. So you can hold a whole lot of gear in here. All this material out here, this ripstop material, is also water resistant. So while I still like to carry a rainfly with me just in case you get a downpour, if it's just a little sprinkle or something like that, or you're walking through the woods in the morning and you got the dew hanging down and dripping onto you, you don't got to worry about your gear getting all messed up or your extra clothes or whatever that's in here getting cold and wet. This will stop it. Now, one of the big differences I've noticed between this new Vapor 2500 and my old Vapor 2500 is the side pouches. If you can see, on the old Vapor 2500 pouches, they come all the way up pretty much the majority of the length of the pack. They have a little elastic band at the top. And while it's nice for, say, my tripod or something, I'll tell you right now, I get a lot of gear lost in here. I have to go fishing for it, digging through it, and even things like water bottles, Nalgene bottles, that kind of stuff get lost in here. On the new one, it doesn't come up as high. You can see it's got the elastic band with a catch on it, so you can adjust the tightness. And it still has the buckles on the side. It's been very nice for some smaller things, and I've still been able to put things like tripods or spotting scopes in there, and I just buckle them down with the buckles and tighten it as I need. It holds it in place no problem. I actually kind of prefer this being a little bit lower than usual. Another major change between the new Vapor and the old Vapor is they have a center internal water pocket. So for anyone that's running the old Vapors, you're probably with me. They used to have a bladder pouch on the left side and over here on the right side. It was super convenient to hang your bladder, but all in all, when you get out hiking and you're in the backcountry, it got a little annoying because all your water is to one side. And what that does is it throws your pack to one side or the other. And it got kind of annoying because as you went throughout the day, you'd start feeling it pulling you a little bit left or a little bit right. Or depending on how you had your pack set up, it would actually shift the whole pack over a little bit. Well, manageable, just a little bit of an annoyance. As you can see here, they now have this center pouch where you can put your bladders in here and keep it nice and centralized, keep it tight to your body, tight to the pack, and it's gonna keep everything nice and secure. The next big upgrade for the new Vapor system versus the old Vapor system is Everly Stock has expanded on their E-Mod system. So you can actually do other attachments onto this pack itself. One of the big ones that I like running is gonna be their EMOD lid. That thing's gonna run you $59.99, and like I've said, you can find them on sale or other websites. If you see these straps down here, they're nice, easy, convenient places for you to buckle it in. You put it on the back of the pack, and it literally just comes right over. You can slide them through there. It's a spring-loaded metal catch. And once you put these in there, they're not going anywhere. Now, if for whatever reason you do need to take it off, you can just unclip it to get into your pack, or just completely take it off and run it even lighter than usual. Now, what I like about this is, like everything in this Vapor series, while it is small, it packs a punch. This thing is 12 inches long by 12 inches wide by 4.5 inches tall, and it adds an extra 800 cubic inches to your pack. It's got two main pouches, both opening towards you. It's got, again, a top pouch where it's super simple to just grab whatever you need, those items that you're getting often. If you want to throw your binos in a case up here, or a call, or a wind check, or maybe just your snacks, or those dude wipes when it's time to go. Perfect place for them. Or if you need a little bit of bigger storage area, you can open this up. You can fit your whole arm inside of here. I think this has been a very good addition to my pack. It's, again, very light, very easy to throw on, take off, and it takes my 2500 pack from holding 2800 cubic inches all the way up to 3600 cubic inches. And at that point, I can make this from a day pack to a couple day pack. I load my old Eberle stock F1 mainframe in the Vapor series. I still have my old 5000 that I'll use for some of our bigger hunts. I don't know that I will try and go to other packs. Obviously, you guys have seen Matt's Franken pack videos, and he tries everything under the sun. I was lucky enough to get this. Find it. I love it. It works great for me. I think it'll work great for you guys. I hope you check it out. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys go out there. I hope you get a tag. I hope you get to kill something. I hope you like and subscribe. Until next time, this has been Scott with Deer and Donuts.